Here we have three quadratic equations. The first one is a quadratic trinomial here. Notice we have each term. We have an x squared, we have a linear term, and we have a constant term. The next two are quadratic binomials. This first one here has a linear term but no constant term. The third one here has no linear term. So these are the three different types of quadratic equations that you're going to run into. Okay, so let's solve the first one here by factoring. Now we have a quadratic trinomial. If it does factor, it's going to factor into the product of two binomials. So let's look at the first term. X squared breaks up as x times x. The factors of 5 are 1 times 5. Now the middle term, positive 4x, has to be gotten from the product of the inner and the outer term. So we have a 5x and a 1x. That adds up to 4x if the 5 is positive and the 1 is negative. Let's go ahead and check. 5 times negative 1 is negative 5. Now that's the hard part, factoring these things, and I'll put a link in the description on how to do that. Once you get it factored, you then set each factor equal to 0. So in this case, x plus 5 equals 0 or x minus 1 equals 0. Now subtracting 5 on both sides, we get our first answer here, x is negative 5, or in this particular case, we'll add 1 to both sides, we get x equals 1. So two solutions to our quadratic equation by factoring. Okay, now let's look at the second one. So here we have a quadratic equation, it's a binomial. Notice here we do have a GCF, and the GCF is x. So if we factor out the x, what'll be left is x plus 4. So this factors. Once you get it factored, you then set each factor equal to 0. So x equals 0 or x plus 4 equals 0. Subtracting 4 here, you get x equals negative 4. All right, so the two solutions are x equals negative 4 or x equals 0. Now for the third equation here that we're going to solve, notice that it is a binomial, but there is no GCF. So I'm going to choose a different method to solve this. I'm going to solve this by extracting square roots. Now the first step is to get the square by itself and then take the square root of both sides. Don't forget to put a plus or minus when you do that so that we don't lose the negative solution. In this case, the square root of x squared is x, and that equals plus or minus the square root of 5. So there really are two solutions here, x equals negative square root of 5 or x equals positive square root of 5. Now to recap, notice here for this first equation, we had a quadratic trinomial, so we factored it and then set each factor equal to 0. For the second equation here, we were able to factor this binomial by factoring out the GCF and then setting each factor equal to 0. For the third equation here, we didn't have a GCF, so we chose to solve by extracting square roots. Taking the square root of both sides, we were able to obtain the two answers. These are the three situations you're going to run into. Now, certainly, you can solve all three of these with the quadratic formula as well. But for that, solve by factoring, there we have it.